About last night, the Bulls beat the Thunder in the United Center thanks to a dominant fourth quarter performance by Derrick Rose, who had 12 of his 29 points in the fourth. Stephen A., has your faith been restored in Rose?
Well, listen, let's be clear about something here. Any faith that I lost in Derrick Rose has very, very little to do with his game. It has to do with his desire to actually play the game of basketball. That's what I've questioned in terms of his quotes, as Joakim Noah would say, says crazy stuff sometimes, gets him in trouble. That's what I've been concerned about with Derrick Rose. Certainly the injuries have you concerned, because when you go through the myriad of injuries, and TNT did an exceptional job last night of just doing, you know, giving us an image of all the injuries he has suffered from. It's like, good Lord have mercy. He's got to wake up with pain in some area every single day. It's a miracle that he's still out there playing. But then he still goes out there. Russell Westbrook, his summer partner, he works out with him in the summer. He blew by him on a couple of occasions, took advantages of mismatches when Enes Kanter found himself, switched over on Derrick Rose along with other people. Still 0-for-9 from three-point range on the season, but found his mid-range game. I was impressed by his quickness, his first step, his explosiveness to the basket, his mid-range jumper. I liked all of those things. With Derrick Rose, there's always a question as to how long it can continue because of the injury issue. And it doesn't even have to be a severe one. Because of the multitude of injuries he suffered from, you never know how much the wear and tear of an 82-game schedule could wear on his body. And some days he doesn't seem to have the lift. He doesn't seem to have the speed. But when you see what you saw last night, it reminds you of how great this kid can be when he's got his game going. There's no question in my mind about that. So, you know, one of the things that I said is that if you're Chicago, paying him $20 million this year, paying him $21 million next season, you know, when you think about the possibility of him moving on, I said yesterday specifically on my radio show, I'm like, don't move him now. Because he came into last night's game having scored 8 points, Skip, in each of the last three games. Well, you don't want to do anything with him when his market is low. What you want him to do is to go out there and play lights out. And then you entertain making a move or making a decision as to whether or not you're going to make the move. Right now, I was impressed with what I saw from him last night. There's no question. But I left feeling there were more questions about Oklahoma City than answers about Derrick Rose. But I was pleased with what I saw from him. And it's impossible, if you know the kid, to actually root against him. He's an incredibly nice kid, and we know that he can play when healthy. It's not like he's some scrub. He's just been suffering from the injury bug. But I saw what I saw last night, and if he can hit his mid-range game and display that kind of speed, he's going to do damage against an awful lot of guys in the NBA, and I think that it's going to bode well for the Chicago Bulls, because we've been looking at Cleveland, Miami, Washington, and Milwaukee, and we sort of forgot about Chicago because Tom Thibodeau had departed. Well, maybe if Derrick Rose keeps this up, we'll revisit the conversation, and it'll include Chicago.
Gut feeling, will he keep this up to this level?
Skip, I think as long as he's healthy enough to play, I don't want to say this level, but it's not going to be as bad as the single digits. I would say to you, do I think that Derrick Rose can average 18 to 20 a night? Yes. Not 29.
I know we're way early in this season. But what struck me after that game was over last night is that that game was something of an indictment of Derrick Rose in his passion or desire or urgency with which he attacks the game of basketball.
Right.
And by the way, I got the last three games at 8, 6, and 4. He did right. have an 8, and then, but the 8 was in a loss at Detroit, and then he only scored 4 in a blowout loss Charlotte.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
All right, so not to no big deal. But right. Okay, so he goes 8, 6, 4. Then he scores 10 in the last 3.5 minutes against the Oklahoma City Thunder of Russell Westbrook and Kevin Durant.
Yep.
Well, that's pretty special stuff. That's all-star stuff. That's former MVP style stuff, right?
Yes.
And I'm thinking, where was that? I'm sure a lot of Bulls fans think, where did that come from, and why don't we see more of that on a nightly basis? I don't know. He is a good kid. He's also a little strange sometimes, a little hard to read, a little, what are you thinking? He's gotten a bunch of bad breaks with his injuries, obviously. Has he come back as quickly as he could? I don't know. But a lot of Bulls fans obviously think he hasn't worked hard enough. Not that he hasn't worked hard enough. He hasn't pushed himself hard enough to take the risk to come back maybe on time. He's taken more time than he probably needed to get completely healthy. So my point is, when we see that kind of explosion, Now he set the bar back up. And I'm wondering, was it prompted? I'm just going to throw this out. Our man Brian Windhorst was on ESPN Radio yesterday and made a strong, bold statement. I think it was yesterday. It might have been the day before. But he said, I think it was the day before. He said that the breakup has begun between Derrick Rose and the Bulls. Like, we're seeing the first signs of it. They're starting to split apart and maybe part ways at some point in the near future. Okay? Do you think that got back to Derrick and it... It hit him. He said, "I'm going to watch this."
I'm going to give Derrick Rose the benefit of the doubt. That eye injury was legit.
Yeah.
Look at him, and
sure.
You can tell how legit
I
it was.
Yeah.
When he sits there and says, "I'm still seeing double," and you look at his eye, one socket higher than the other, I mean, it's believable, okay? So you take that into account, and you talk about how you just had to sit on the couch for a couple of weeks. You weren't allowed to do anything and just finding your rhythm,
that's
raising your blood pressure up. All of those things are fair and they're legitimate on his part. So because of that, I can't sit up there and just say, well, he just seemed to work harder in this game than he did in others. He may have been going through things in others that he didn't go through last night. But in the end, Brian Windhorst is absolutely correct. And logic says so. Because if you're the Chicago Bulls moving forward, how can you plan a future with Derrick Rose, considering not only the plethora of injuries he has suffered from and how much he's been debilitated despite his youth, but on top of it all, how so concerned he appears to be about it that he speaks about life beyond basketball seemingly at every turn. Mm-hmm. If you're the Chicago Bulls, that's not somebody that you can enjoy paying $20+ million to per year. So I think that everybody knows what Brian Windhorst was saying, and I think Brian Windhorst was absolutely right to say so.
And by the way, just a quick thought on your man Westbrook. I know they were back-to-back, the Thunder, but he's now 1-for-12 in his last two fourth quarters, just for the record. He only took 4 shots last night and missed all of them, but he made sure his man Kevin Durant took 8 shots and made 4 of them. They were in position at 94-all until Derrick Rose turn back into Derrick Rose, right?
Well, they got to figure in Oklahoma City. They got to figure out some things. But I mean, the bottom line is Russell Westbrook didn't have the greatest night, and he still finished with 20, 10, and 8. So I mean, we all know what he could do. And Kevin Durant, we know that he doesn't usually shoot 13-for-29. It's usually less shots and more made shots than that. So you know that's not going to last. But somehow, some way, the Ibakas, the Cantors, the Waiters, you've got to find a way to fit these guys in to a relatively new system that Billy Donovan has employed.
So you're going to have to figure that out. That's 3 games they lost late. And the one at Orlando, which I watched, they should have lost it late. And I told you, Russell banked in like a 40-foot three-pointer straight on at the buzzer to send it into overtime.
Takes time. Yep. Takes time.
It was good to see D. Rose back to his old self. Can Andrew Luck bounce back? He replaced Peyton Manning as the Colts quarterback 4 seasons ago. Now Luck leads the league with 12 interceptions. Manning is tied for second with 11. When we return, we'll